Let us know about the concept of operators in R. Before going to that, let us know how comments are written in R. Generally, comments are the non-executive block of codes or statements in the program. They are only used to present the code in an understandable way. In R, the symbol hash is used to specify a statement as a comment. For example, if we see that here hash this is my first comment is a comment, where the symbol hash specifies that the statement or block of code which is following that is a non-executable statement. The purpose of comments is to only specify the purpose of the code which is written. Let us revert back to our topic, operators and operands. The symbol which is used to perform an operation on the given data is called an operator. Also, the data or variables on which the operation is being performed is called operands. For example, if we see y equal to 35 minus 7, here the symbol of subtraction is called an operator, as it performs an operation of subtraction of 7 from 35. Also, c equal to a plus b is an equation where the symbol of addition is operator, as it adds both the values of a and b. If we come to operands, the numbers 35 and 7 are operands, as the operation of subtraction is being performed on 35 and 7. In the same way, if we see in the second example, the variables a and b are called operands, as the operation of addition is being performed on variables a and b. In R, there are 5 types of operators, which are arithmetic, relational, assignment, logical, and miscellaneous operators. Let us know each of them briefly. The first one is arithmetic operators. The operators which are used to perform arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and so many, then such operators are called arithmetic operators. In R, the arithmetic operations are performed on a set of values in the form of vectors or any other data types. The arithmetic operators supported by R are plus, minus, multiplication, division, double percentile, which gives the remainder of the division. Also, cap symbol, which gives the value of a variable raised to the power of another variable. Also, the symbol percentile divided percentile gives the value of quotient on partial division. Let us see an example about arithmetic operators. Here we have defined two vectors v1 and v2. V1 is assigned with a vector of values 10, 25, 16 and 48, whereas the vector v2 is given the vector values of 2, 14, 8 and 9. Here we added a command hash for addition. This statement is non-executable, as this is a comment to show that we are performing addition now. Okay. So we have again defined a variable a which takes the added values of v1 and v2. After defining this, if we give a command to print a, then it prints the following values: 12, which is addition of 10 plus 2, 39, which is addition of 25 plus 14, 24, which is addition of 16 and 8, and 57, which is the addition of 48 and 9. Next, for subtraction, we have given a statement a, which is assigned with the value of v1 minus v2. If we give a command print a, then it prints 8, 11, 8 and 39, which is the differences of corresponding elements of first vector and second vector. For multiplication, we have given a statement a, which takes the values of v1 multiplied by v2. And if we give a command to print a, then it gives the following values of 20, 350, 128 and 432, which are the product values of corresponding values of v1 and v2 vectors. Next, for division, we given a command a, which is assigned with v1 divided by v2. And if we give a command to print a, then we get 5.00, 1.7857, 2.00, 5.3333. which is the quotient values of v1 elements divided by the corresponding v2 elements. Next, for remainder, we take a assigned with a value of v1 percentile percentile v2, which means when v1 elements are divided with v2 elements, then we will get some sort of reminders. Such values are given here if we take print A, and the remaining values are 0, 11, 0 and 3. Coming to the next, for exponent raised to power, we give the command AV1 raised to V2. If we give a command print A, then we get the following values. And for quotient of partial division, we use the operator percentile divided percentile values. And if we give the command to print A, then we get the following quotient values when V1 elements are partially divided with V2 elements. The next type of operators are relational operators. They are used for comparison purpose of corresponding elements of two vectors. So as we are comparing two values, then there will be only result of true or false. The relational operators which are supported by R are greater than, less than, greater than equal to, less than equal to, double equal to, which compares the two values are equal or not, and not equal to, which compares the two values are not equal or they are equal. If we see an example of relational operators, we have taken two vectors V1 with the vector elements of 21, 78, 45 and 1435. And V2 vector with the elements of 48, 64, 304 and 1435. If we say print V1 less than V2, which means every element of V1 is compared with the corresponding element of V2, whether it is less than or not. So let us take first element 21. Is 21 less than 48? Yes, that is true. So the result is true. Is 78 less than 64? No. So the result is false. Is 45 less than 304? Yes, the result is true. And is 1435 less than 1435? No, as these two are equal, so the result is false. In the same way, if we say print V1 greater than V2, then we get the following result. Again, if we say that print V1, which is less than equal to V2 or not, then if we compare the first elements, is 21 less than or equal to 48? True, as 21 is less than 48. So the result is true. Is for 78 less than equal to 64? No, it is not less than or not equal to 64. Thus the result is false. Is 45 less than or equal to 304? Yes, which is true. So the result is true. And 1435 is equal to 1435. So here the result is also true. In the same way, if we give the command to print V1 is greater than equal to V2, then we get the following result. If we come to another operator, print V1 equal to V2, which means two elements are compared to see whether they are equal or not. So, is 21 equal to 48? No. So, the result is false. Is 78 equal to 64? No. So, the result is false. Is 45 equal to 304? No. So, the result is again false. But if 1435 is equal to 1435, this is true. So, the result is true. In the same way, if we say print V1 not equal to V2, which means we have to print true for the values not equal to each other. So, we get the following output. The next type of operator is assignment operator. We have previously learned how to assign the values to variables. In the same way, we use the assignment operators. In brief, there are two types of assignment operators. One is the left assignment operator, which is the left-headed arrow or left double-headed arrow or equal to. These are called left assignment operators because the values which are present in the right side of the operator are assigned to the left side values of variable. Also, the right assignment operators are right-headed arrow and double right-headed arrow. These are called right assignment operators because the values on the present in the left side of these operators are assigned to the right side variables. For example, if we see left assignment, then we have given V1 with the value of 24.5, V2 which is assigned by using a double headed arrow with value 32, and V3 is assigned by operator equal to with the value of freshers world. If we print V1, then the value will be 24.5 as assigned, V2 will be 32 and V3 will be freshers world. In the same way, if we see right assignment, then the value of the left side of the operator is assigned to the right side variable. So, if we print V1 and V2, we get the corresponding given values. The next operator is logical operators. The logical operators are only applied for vectors that contains logical, numeric or boolean or complex type of data. For every value which is greater than 1 is considered as true, and the other values which are less than 1 are considered as false. These considerations are because logical operators only works with the values of true and false and gives the same result as true or false. So in R, there are three types of logical operators. The first one is logical AND, the second one is logical OR, and the third one is logical NOT. Let's see an example. If two vectors we have defined like this, that the vector V has values 0, 1, true and 3i, which is a complex number, and also the second vector T with values 4, 5, false and 3i. If we apply logical AND, then we give a command to print V and T. Okay, so here logical AND is used, so the output will be true only if both the conditions are true. The output will be false if any of the condition is false. So by comparing the first two values, the first element of V vector is 0, which is less than 1, so this is a false value. In T vector, the first element is 4, which is greater than 1, so it is a true value. But the logical AND relationship between false and true is false, so the result is false. In the same way, the second element of V vector is 1, the second element of V vector is true, both of them are greater than true, and the logical AND relationship between true and true will be true, so the result is true. Here if we come to the string values, the first one is true and the corresponding value is false. So the AND relationship between true and false is false. But the fourth value, which is a complex number in both these vectors, is 3i. These both are greater than 1. So the logical AND relationship between both of these will be true. In the same way, if we come to logical R, if any one of the condition is true, then the entire condition will be giving the output true. So if we compare V with T with logical OR operator, so in the first element of V there is 0, so it is false. In the first element of T, the value is 4, which is greater than 1, which means it is true. So the logical AND relationship between true and false is true, so the output is true. In the same way, if we see the second elements of V and T, then they both are true, and the logical OR relationship between true and true is true. If we see the third string values in V and T are true and false, so the logical OR relationship between true and false is true. In the same way, the next complex corresponding elements are true, so the output will be true. If we come to logical NOT, then it is only applicable for one vector, which means if one element is true, it prints the reverse of it. If the element is true and we apply logical NOT, then the output will be false. So if we have applied logical NOT to vector V, if we see the first element of vector V, which is 0 and less than 1, so the value is false. If we apply logical NOT to this, it becomes true, so the output is true. The next element is 1, greater than 0, so if we apply logical NOT, then it becomes false. The next element is true, so when we apply logical NOT, it becomes false. In the same way, the 3i is greater than 1, which means it is true value. But if we apply logical NOT, then it becomes false. Hope you all understand this concept. Moving on to the next operator, which is the miscellaneous operators. These operators are not used for logical or mathematical purpose. They are only meant for specific purpose. In examples, we would be understanding it better. So there are in R, there are three types of miscellaneous operators. The first one is colon operator, which creates a number of series. In examples, we would understand about it better. So in R, there are three types of miscellaneous operators. The first one is colon operator, which creates a series of numbers between two values. Next is percentile in percentile operator, which is used to check whether an element is present in the vector or not. And the next operator is percentile star percentile, which is used to multiply a matrix with its transpose. If we come to an example of colon operator, we have taken a variable with V, which takes the values 3 colon 12. 3 colon 12 means it takes the value starting from 3 ending with 12. If we give a command print v, then we get the values of 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. So this is the use of colon operator. The next one is percentile in percentile operator. So if we want to check whether an element 6 is present in the vector v or not, we can use percentile in percentile operator. So we have assigned a element e with value of 6 and we are giving a command print e percentile in percentile v, which means we have to check whether e element is present in the vector v or not. Here the output is true because 6 is present in the vector v. In the same way, if we take the element as 2 and we want to check whether 2 is present in v or not, thus we have given a command e percentile in percentile v, which gives the result as false because the value 2 is not present in the vector v. Coming to the next operator, which is for matrix multiplication with its transpose, which is percentile star percentile. Here first we have defined a matrix M with values 3, 6, 8, 2, 16, 9 with number of rows 2, number of columns 3, and the arrangement of these values is through by row. And we have taken a variable R which is equal to M percentile star percentile T of M. Here T of M the transpose of matrix M, and we print the result R, then we get the corresponding matrix which we would obtain by multiplying the matrix M with its transpose. Hope you all like this video. For more videos, do subscribe to our channel. We would discuss about control structures in tomorrow's videos.